So before we derive the OLS estimators, we need to know some basics about the summation operators. So I've got three equations here. These are all basic equations of summation operators that we need to know to derive the least squares estimators. So in the first equations, I've got summation of xi minus x bar equals to 0. In the second equation, I've got summation of xi minus x bar whole square equals to summation of xi multiplied by xi minus x bar. And in the third equation, I've got summation of xi minus x bar multiplied by yi minus y bar equals to summation of xi multiplied by yi minus y bar, or it could be also written as summation of yi multiplied by xi minus x bar. So I'm going to show you how to derive these equations first. So the first equation, let's see. So the first equation says summation of I equals to 1 to n xi minus x bar equals to 0. So let's prove this one. So we can write this as summation of I equals to 1 to n xi minus summation of I equals to 1 to n x bar, and then we can keep this as it is, summation of I equals to 1 to n xi. And since this is the x bar, so we can write it as n x bar, and then we can summation of I equals to 1 to n xi and minus n. Since this is x bar, as in this is the average, we can write this as 1 divided by n summation of I equals to 1 to n xi. So this is simply just the average. And so n and n will just cross each other out. So we can write this as n I equals to 1 xi and minus summation of n I equals to 1 xi. So this is basically just 0. So this is our first proof. So now we're going to prove the second equation, which says xi minus x bar whole square equals to summation of xi multiplied by xi minus x bar. Summation xi multiplied by xi minus x bar. So if we take out the left hand side here and write it as it is, I equals to 1 to n xi minus x bar whole square, and let's just apply the formula of a minus b whole square. So summation of I equals to 1 to n and xi square minus 2 xi x bar plus x bar square. Now I'm going to write I equals to 1 to n xi square, and if we break this apart, we can write it as xi x bar minus xi x bar plus x bar square. And if we now say rearrange it, so we can get summation of I equals to 1 to n xi square minus xi x bar, and minus summation of I equals to 1 to n, and we've got xi x bar minus x bar squared. So moving on over here, we can write, we can take out xi from here. So if we take out xi from here, we can get summation of I equals to 1 to n. If we take out xi, we get xi minus x bar. And so summation of I equals to 1, I equals to 1 to n. So if we take out x bar from here, we can get x bar, so xi minus x bar. So leave it as it is. So summation of I equals to 1 to n xi multiplied by xi minus x bar. And since this is x bar, we can take it out of the summation operator. So we are getting x bar summation of I equals to 1 to n and xi minus x bar. So in the previous equation, we've proved that xi minus x bar equals to 0. So if this is 0, this whole thing would be just 0. So we are just left with summation of I equals to 1 to n xi multiplied by xi minus x bar. So this is the same as this. So our equation is proved. So now we're going to prove the third equation, which is summation of xi minus x bar multiplied by yi minus y bar equals to summation of xi multiplied by yi minus y bar, or we can also prove it as summation of yi multiplied by xi minus x bar. So if we take the left hand side here, and we can just, and first of all, write it just as it is. So summation of I equals to 1 to n xi xi minus x bar and yi minus y bar. So I'm just going to multiply this, and summation of I equals to 1 to n, and I will get like xi yi minus xi y bar minus x bar yi plus x bar y bar. And if I rearrange it, we can write it as summation of I equals to 1 and xi yi minus xi y bar, and we can take this on summation of I equals to 1 to n x bar yi minus x bar y bar. So now we are just going to take out xi from here. So we can write I equals to 1 to n, taking out xi, and we can, this will be yi minus y bar. And in the same way we can take out x bar out of here. So x bar yi minus y bar. Okay, so moving on here, let's see here. So I've got summation of I equals to 1 to n xi yi minus y bar. And let's just take out x bar out of the summation operator, like in the previous example. So x bar, and we can write summation of I equals to 1 to n, and we can write yi minus y bar. So since xi minus x bar equals to 0, so yi minus y bar will also be 0. So this whole thing would be just 0, like in the previous example. So all we are left with is summation of I equals to 1, 1 to n xi yi minus y bar. So this and this are the same thing. So this is proved. And to prove this one, we just have to rearrange this line just a bit differently. And I'm going to show you in another page. Let's see here. So let's write the left hand side again. That is summation of I equals to 1 to n and xi minus x bar yi minus y bar. And if we multiply this, we can get summation of I equals to 1 to n. If we multiply this, we can just like get this same line again, you know, in the previous example, minus xi y bar minus x bar yi plus x bar y bar. Now we're just going to rearrange this a little bit different way than the previous one. So summation of I equals to 1 to n, and we can take out xi yi minus x bar yi, and we can also write summation of I equals to 1 to n and xi y bar and minus x bar y bar. So if we take out yi from this, we can write it as I equals to 1 to n, take out yi, and we can write xi minus x bar minus summation of I equals to 1 to n. We can take out y bar out of here, so y bar, so xi minus x bar. So just like in the previous example, this would also be 0. We can take out y bar out of there, and if we take out y bar out of the summation operator, xi minus x bar will essentially be just be 0. So this is 0. So all we're left with is this one. So summation of I equals to 1 to n yi xi minus x bar. So this proves this one. So this one is also proved. Thank you.